the music. So I started uploading my my video logs onto YouTube. I started putting my Twitch vlogs, VODs or whatever, on YouTube. So now I have. Did I put stroke enough? Whatever, it's fine. You guys know what I'm, you know, doing. Whatever you're gonna make, I would love some, even though I ate already, but I can make room. Hey, anybody can make room. If you work hard and believe in yourself, you can make room for any food in your stomach. Well, I wouldn't recommend that, but you know, it's nice. So anyway, today's gonna be a nice chill stream. Tomorrow I'm gonna be making pasta from scratch, and then we're gonna make ourselves a nice shrimp Alfredo, which is gonna be amazeballs. Well, I hope it's going to be amazeballs. I'm, you know, have to cross myself, make sure everything works out today. I am cooking stroganoff for the first time, so hopefully it turns out pretty good. So we'll see what happens. So let me get started. Get started with the prep cam. Oh, look, it's Steve the starter. So this is week number 2 with our sourdough starter, Steve. Hello, Steve. What's up, buddy? I fed him a couple hours ago. So you can see that he's already starting to bubble up and yeast up. The smell is really strong. The beer smell is kind of what you want to go for. That yeasty kind of beerish smell is kind of what you want to go for when you have a sourdough starter like this. By the way, the sourdough starter level is actually only up to here, but because of the bubbling, he gets really, really high up there and has a possibility of overbubbling outside of this container. So I've been watching him like a hawk. Lulaboo, what do you call a bull masturbating? Beef stroke enough. Oh my god. Lula making beef stroke me off? Yes, that's exactly what I'm making. Absolutely. You got me. You got me, you guys. That's what I'm making. So, I have to go in here. I want to, like, punch down the starter a little bit so that he doesn't get anything. Watching you on my iPad while I make maple glazed salmon and some kind of brown rice. Not sure how to season it yet. Ooh, chicken stock or chicken bouillon if you have it. Would be good with the rice. So anyway, we're going to punch down or at least take out the air bubbles inside Steve the starter. So he's getting a really nice smell right now. He is, he's getting, you know, really flavor developed. I like to leave Steve out in room temperature sometimes so that he can, you know, develop more flavor a little bit faster. Because it's always a good idea. But for now, for most of the week, he's been in the fridge. If you leave your sourdough starter in the fridge, you only have to feed it once a week. If you are leaving it on room temperature, it's 12 hours on the clock to, like, get your sourdough starter going. So if you kind of look at it, I always try and break up the gluten strands when I'm in here, all up in this breezy. Thank you for the new follows. You guys are awesome. We're getting close to 20K followers on Twitch, too. That's pretty cool. Woop, woop. Thanks, everybody. Hey Lula, hey everybody, what's up Indigo Rona, how you doing today? Alrighty, well this stream's off to a rousing start, I know, right? So, anyway, I'm just kind of punching down, getting rid of the air holes that the yeast is making when they produce carbon dioxide, eating the new flour that I fed it with this morning. So we're going to take 6 ounces of this starter, we're going to make some sourdough bread rolls. So I'm going to start with that first, mixing that all together, and then we're going to get started on the beef stroganoff, because it is going to take a little bit for the sourdough to process. So hopefully if we manage our time wisely, we'll be able to have a nice complete-ish dinner. So we'll see what happens. So beef stroganoff, beef, mushrooms, shallots. We're gonna put a splash of alcohol in there when we deglaze the pan eventually. So there's wide egg noodles. Egg noodles for beef stroganoff, the best. I love stuff. 10 more followers to 20k, awesome. Is it 10k followers? I can't tell. Dark stroganoff, I know, right? Alright, so color correction's Steve's really fucking with the color correction every time I mess with him, so I'm gonna stop fucking with him. He's punched down, but eventually we're gonna have to get 6 ounces of our starter and put it into our sourdough recipe that we're gonna put together right now. So I'm gonna bust out Bert, the KitchenAid stand mixer, so we can get started on that. So I'm gonna leave that there really quick, I gotta wash my hands. Oh, Oh god, I have to put the points up. Hang on a second. Hi Lulaboo, how you doing? Hello, hello, big troll, how are you today? Welcome, welcome. Let me get started. Let me get that Revlo going because I don't want you guys to be not with any, you know, Revlo stuff. I don't know why I never freaking remember to launch it. I do my best, you guys. I do my best. I just had Stroganoff for lunch. Yay! So it's my first time making Stroganoff. We're gonna see how it goes. I'm pretty sure it's gonna be, you know, pretty awesome. So I'm pretty okay with that. Yay, cookies. Yeah, you can I can bake your ass a batch of cookies if you manage to make it. Dude, Steve's already bubbling. Like, this is a really active yeast starter because he's already starting to bubble right after I punched him down. This is really exciting. Like I said, he's had a week to flavor develop and I've left him out room temperature, so it's gonna be really good. I'm really excited about this. There's a fly in here and it's driving me bananas. You're making me hungry. That's it, I'm ordering food now. Well, yes, if you're hungry, go eat food. Moderation, y'all. Alrighty, so let's get our ingredients. Time to get ingredients. Oh, I need bread flour. Speaking of bread flour. So, this is my my bread flour bin. Obviously it's a little empty, but fear not! For somebody decided to go into my Amazon wish list and buy out all of my flour that I had on the wish list, which was my fault that I had put so many packets of units of flour in my wish list, but I burned through so much flour, it's not funny, so I didn't think it was an issue, but somebody bought out all of my flour, so now I own legit 8 bags of flour. Four all-purpose flour, 4 5-pound bags of all-purpose flour, 4 5-pound bags of bread flour. So whoever did that, thank you. And thank you, Chick Drummer, for the hosting. I appreciate it greatly. Thank you, Chick Drummer, and the support. So let me go get it. Holy crap. So I have legit 8 bags of these in my pantry right now. Why don't you go to Costco and get flour there? Isn't it super cheap at Costco? Oh yeah, it totally is. Totally is. I had a couple of people in chat request for a wish list from me. So I decided to make an Amazon wish list, but I decided I didn't want to put very expensive items in there, but I wanted to put items that are, you know, helpful to the live stream. So what I ended up doing was making a wish list of all the really cheap items that I use all the time, which is flour, non-cooking spray. I want to start putting like baking powder, baking soda once I run out of that or start to run low on that. So I didn't want to make an expensive wish list item, and now I'm kind of backfiring a little bit because now, like, it's all here. It's all here. Hey, honey, how are you? Yeah, I'm gonna be doing a lot more bread baking, which is the reason why I'm gonna make sourdough bread rolls today. And then tomorrow, once I make my pasta, I'm gonna make pasta from scratch tomorrow, but I'm also going to try to make, you know, French bread so we can make more garlic bread tomorrow. Ooh, I should be on that list. I bet you go through a lot of it. Oh, I do. I go through a lot of flour. Lots and lots of flour. I appreciate that you guys are helping me with that. Thank you. But I'm leaving the more expensive items that I'm going to get myself. So, you know, like meats and cheeses and stuff like that. It's hard to ship through Amazon anyway, so I'm not going to leave that as an option. So I figured the cheap stuff that Amazon Pantry has available would be a good option. So I did. Is this channel all baking? No, we're making beef stroganoff today, so we're cooking and baking today. Yay. But mostly, like, lately it's been all baking. I've been making, well, sort of. Last week I made clam chowder from scratch, and I used clam chowder with sourdough bread bowl, so I did sourdough for the first time. Turned out pretty okay. I overproofed it, or I didn't tighten up the dome for the sourdough bread. Either one of those. One of those was the reason why it just overproofed and was just all wobbly wobbly after I baked it, so I wanted to try again. I do not like failure, so I will practice again until I get it right. Same thing with challah bread. I'm going to make more challah bread because I overproofed that as well. And I do not want to overproof my bread again, so I will definitely do the due diligence I need, take my time. I'm really just gonna slow things down today. It's gonna be a really chill stream. I know you've answered this before, but why do you put flour in that bin? It's easier for me to store it. It's nice and locking in. It locks in, I use a lot of it. And it helps preserve the flour. Sometimes if it's not that I have this problem here, but in our first crappy apartment, we were paranoid about, you know, animals, you know, possibly if there was like a mouse or a rat situation, animals kind of tearing into this paper bag and just going after the flour. So I didn't want that to happen. I wanted to make sure that we have everything nice and stored properly. It helps keep the flour longer. You know, things won't get in it. It's nice. Alrighty, so we have my bread flour. So I need to measure out the ingredients for the sourdough. So we're gonna need 3 tablespoons of active dry yeast.
It's in the mail.
I got something in the mail? Oh shit! Yay, more stuff in the mail! Oh, somebody got my wish list item. So I changed the wish list item to something that was cheaper. Like for some reason, nonstick cooking spray that I had put on there went from $3 to $7. I was like, nope. No cooking spray is gonna cost that much and I'm gonna make you guys pay for it. So I went and found a cheaper alternative cooking spray and somebody bought it on the wish list. Thank you. Thanks, I'm trying to open it up right now. Oh yay, somebody got the Trader Joe's one. Yeah, what? It came with a card, this is cool. Alrighty, so. Let me open up this card really quick. So what's your kitchen like? It's actually quite big. I have a double oven, a gas burner, a microwave over the stove, lots of counter space, lots of cabinet space. It's a really beautiful kitchen. Like, look at this granite as fuck right here. Love it. Ooh, did you order your water bottle?
Yeah.
Nice.
I think
something
the one you got me from
that. Oh, okay. Hi, Lulaboo. Enjoy your gift from Veronica, aka Latin Pretty Girl. Thank you so much, Latin Pretty Girl in chat, for this. I'll have to screenshot this later so that I can, put a thank you on Twitter. So thank you. This is like all handwritten. It's so nice right now. I love it. So, yay. More nonstick spray. I needed it too. I was running out. I am excited. Hey Tally, Indy says hi. Alrighty, so let me get the hot water. And let me get the active dry yeast. There we go. So we're gonna need to do some measuring. Yeah, I know it's your granite top. Nice for cleaning. Yeah, it's nice. It is. That was really nice handwriting, too. Some penmanship poured right there. So, I need to get my scale. Oh, shit. Sorry. There we go. So, I actually don't need the flour right now. I'm going to need my yeast here. And I got to measure out 15 grams of yeast. Active dry yeast. Come on, zero out. Come on, buddy. There we go. There we go. So we need 15 grams. Seven, eight, nine, 10. Come on. Oh, got it. 15 grams of yeast right here, active dry. Okay, so then we're gonna need some hot water. We're gonna start with 2 ounces. 2 ounces of hot water. It's gonna go in here. It's gonna make it get hot.
Yes, thank you, honey.
gonna do salt. We're gonna mix this together, 2 ounces hot water. We're gonna have to make sure this combines well. So let me just grab.
Do I even have any more plastic spoons? One plastic spoon left, yay!
Alrighty, so warm to hot water to help activate this yeast. I kind of like stir it around so we can declumpify it, I guess you can say. If you've seen my streams already, you know I do this so many times. This is kind of just standard stuff, you know what I mean? So we're going to mix this up, we're going to measure the rest of our ingredients while this is activating. So we're going to need, we're going to have the starter, 6 ounces of hot water, 6 ounces of bread flour, and we're going to put that in our KitchenAid stand mixer. So it's going to be nice. We got to set up Burton stuff, so it's going to be pretty cool. So what games have you guys been playing lately? I've noticed that Dark Souls 3 came out today. Yay, Dark Souls, for everybody who loves to, you know, who's a glutton for punishment. Hello. Hey, Lula, how are you? Hello, Miamixes, how are you today? I'm doing really good. I get to cook again today, so I'm always having a good day when I get to cook. Yay. So, I'm not a fan, personally, of Dark Souls because I'm not good at those games, first of all. Second of all, I have kind of a rage. I get mad, really frustrated at video games. Tally knows this. I used to play League of Legends back when League of Legends first came out, and I would just yell and son of a bitch! Ah! You know, it was just bad. I've broken several pieces of hardware because of it. So I can't play League anymore because of that. So I try to stay away from anything that's gonna make me rage, because I just don't wanna break anything anymore. I'd like to keep my peripherals, thanks. Where's your whisk? Oh, the whisk is too small for this. Plus, it's metal. The one that's small enough to actually fit in here is metal, and that's not going to do for this. Not at all. Alright, so this looks well mixed and activated. This is a plastic spoon, I promise. It just looks like metal because I got it for Thanksgiving so I could feel extra fancy. Oh, this is live! I thought it was a playlist from last night. No, no, Thor. No, I turned off the playlist. This is live. TOR with a new chapter, and then the Masters of Orion Lula got me addicted to. Oh my god, I love Master of Orion. I could play Master of Orion all day. Alright, so we gotta get 6 ounces of our starter. Might as well put it in the bowl that I'm gonna mix it in. Alrighty, so we gotta just measure out our stuff here. I'm going a little bit ahead of myself. I'm trying not to. So in here, we're gonna put our 1 pound of bread, 1 pound, excuse me, of bread flour. I'm just gonna measure out our stuff again. Thank you so much for the hosting, Indie Corona, for the host. Thank you. You awesome lady. I am literally taking my sweet ass time today. Things are gonna be a little bit chill, a little bit more relaxed. I don't wanna get overly, I don't know, man. I woke up this morning, not a lot of energy. So I'm hoping, I have a cup of tea. I have like strong tea right now so I can like try and get my ass a little bit rubbed up. If I am desperate, I have coffee. Tally still has black crack coffee, napalm, and death wish coffee that I can use if I really, really, really want to get some more energy in me today. I don't think it's necessary. I think we can just kind of take it nice and slow and have ourselves a nice good time. Everybody just chill out. Today's gonna be a good day. We're gonna be going to our nice bread baking. It's gonna be fun. And if this fucking fly, came in when we went to go check the mail yesterday, it's been driving me bananas. Like, absolutely bananas. Alrighty, so 6 ounces of this flour is going into the bowl that I'm going to be mixing with the starter. Okay, so I just need to get 6 ounces. There we go. So 6 ounces of flour is in the bowl that we're gonna start mixing with. And then we gotta put in the 6 ounces of water. And then we gotta put the sourdough starter in here. So we're gonna do that soon. Let me just put the bread flour away. We no longer need it. What's beef stroganoff? Amazing. Okay, so beef stroganoff is a, let's say, beef broth, shallots. I'm gonna splash some red wine in there. Salt and pepper, beef broth, oh my lord, beef. We're gonna sear the beef. We're gonna deglaze the pan that the beef was seared in. We're gonna stick all those bitty juicy bits into the sauce that goes into the stroganoff. Oh, and mushrooms. Mushrooms, mushrooms, mushrooms all over the place with the beef stroganoff as well. So beef, mushrooms, shallots in a nice beef broth sauce that's been thickened. Salt and pepper, a little bit of a splash of wine. And sour cream. Yes, I have, and a splash of sour cream with on top of egg noodles. And that's beef stroganoff. Okay, so let me get the 6 ounces. So anyway, let's measure out our 6 ounces of our sourdough starter. Lord almighty. Alrighty. Okay, so 6 ounces of starter, here we go. It's gonna be a little messy. Let me just mix this up one last time. Iron Chef is still running on TV? It really is! Oh, I love Iron Chef. I actually, late night Food Network would broadcast OG, you know, Japanese Iron Chef episodes, and I actually like those a lot better than everything else. God damn it, Fly! I swear to God. Is on this weekend. No, he's gonna die in a few days. It's okay, we'll just die in a few days. Mods! We have one mod, right? Thank you! Thank you! Alright, we're gonna keep going. Oh, I loved Morimoto. Oh, I loved Morimoto too. I remember the first time I ever laid eyes on Bobby Flay was on Iron Chef Japan, and I hated his guts. Thank you, Jaded. You're awesome. Dude, mods are on top of it. Yay. It's a really chill stream. Like, I normally don't have to do very much in this live stream because everybody's on top of it here. Like, I don't... Here's the music on. I can't hear the music. It might be because I'm using headphones, but, you know, whatever. Yes, I'm quite hands-on. I get real down and dirty when I do stuff, cooking-wise. Because it's nice. I like to be able to, like, you know, I get really interactive with the food. Let me just wash my hands really quick. Okie dokie. So, we need our 6 ounces of hot water. Gotta run that water till it's nice and warm. Yeah, I didn't like Bobby Flay at first. Now he's okay. He's alright. He's alright. I'm not... huge fan of Bobby Flay, but I'm not gonna knock him either because there's a lot of people who don't like Bobby Flay either. But you know, the people who watch, you know, try to beat Bobby Flay, you know, competition cooking show and just watch him so that he can get his butt kicked, totally fine. You want to know why? Because Bobby Flay is laughing his ass to the bank. You watch that show to see him beat, but he's the one who wins overall. He's making money off of that Food Network show. Alright, so our yeast is definitely getting activated. It's super foamy. It's a good sign. It's a good sign. We have nice, healthy, active yeast. Yay. I gotta bust out Bert now. Alright, so here's our 6 ounces of water right there. Gotta make room now for Bert. Time for Bert to make his debut today. Oh my god, man. I swear to god, he gets heavier and heavier every time I get him. Every time I use him or pick him up, I swear he's getting heavier. Man, I need to get a pet or something because I can't keep treating Bert like my makeshift dog. Just dumb. Did we hit 20,000 followers? Holy crap! We hit 20,000 followers on Twitch! Oh my god! Yes! Holy crap! Oh my god, you guys! Yes! Thank you! Thank you so much, everybody, for following and putting up with my ass while I cook my way through oblivion here. I appreciate it greatly. You guys are pretty legit. Wow, thank you. Yes, 20,000 followers on Twitch. Same week that I hit 5K followers on Twitter. Follow me at fail_Lula if you want to see some pictures. Eventually, I'm going to step up my... game a little bit on the social medias. I promise. But yes, celebration, bitches. Fuck yes. Oh my lord. Yes. Self five right here. Yes. Yes. All right. So let's put together our water starter, active dry yeast. Here's our 6 ounces of water. Here's the last remaining 2 ounces of water with the yeast in there, going all up in. And then we're going to add our starter, which is going to add a lot of good flavors in there, especially now since it's got to develop a little bit more flavor over time. Not as much as if it were sitting in my fridge for a month or two, but you know, it's okay. It's going to be amazing. It's going to be amazing flavor over time. We're going to keep feeding Steve, and we're going to keep, you know, making Steve better. So it's going to be pretty awesome. Yes! Give him a sub button, Twitch, sniff, yay! Somebody should make food for the apocalypse. That would be cool. Now it should be win_Lula. That's funny. Well, I didn't know. Okay, so when I started my Twitter account, it was before all the Twitch stuff happened, okay? I started my Twitter not knowing I was gonna do stuff on Twitch, not even knowing what Twitch was. I think Twitch was still Justin TV at the time, and Tally had just started a Twitter account, and I had to make sure I was following him, and you know, because he was like, yeah, I think Twitter would be a good idea for me while I'm doing Justin, so I can tell people when I go live, because at the time there wasn't really an email notification telling you when you were gonna go live, so we were relying heavily on Twitter. As the way everybody does today. It was equally more important now than it was back then equally as important now as it was back then. The good old days, right, Indy? So we're gonna let that mix together a little bit. It's already getting nice and bubbly, I appreciate it. I still gonna get my half ounce of kosher salt. So while this is mixing, let me get that half ounce of kosher salt and put it in the flour mixture that's still not in there yet. Remember, we still have 10 ounces of flour that we still have to put in here. Right now, it's just getting mixed together into this nice soupy little thing. I watched Justin TV. It was such a letdown when they shut it down. Feels bad, man. They shut down Justin right before the Amazon thing, so I can imagine it was a condition of the Amazon buyout in general, but you know, you can't blame them. You know, when you're about to get Amazon level funding, I would be like, I will do as you say, master, whatever you want. Like, I will bow down to your authority for that good old Amazon thing. Do not blame them one bit for shutting down Justin. It sucks, but it is, you know, Justin was starting to turn into more of a business, less of a casual, underground thing, and turning into a more mainstream thing. I mean, Twitch is getting more and more of the streaming internet stuff lately, so yeah. Oh, there's something, it didn't pop up. Oh well, I'm a mother trucker for now. Who loves waffles? Thank you so much for subscribing to the channel. Welcome to the convoy, mother trucker. Toot toot. Thank you. Appreciate it. Yeah. I still got you, buddy. Still got you. Also, new mod, congrats. Yay. Lots of good things happening this week, I'm excited. So we're going to turn this up a little bit so we can certainly tune this up a little bit more thoroughly. Once that's more thoroughly mixed up, alright, cool. So now we're going to put our kosher salt slash flour into our mix here so that we can get ourselves a nice dough ball formation happening here. This mixer is irritating. Your name's irritating. I'm just kidding. Don't worry. This is gonna have to happen for a while, so. This is gonna be a little bit. Don't worry, it's not gonna run the entire time. Bert does get shit done, I have to say. So we're gonna let this happen here. Oh, Red Dragon 1982, thank you so much for the donation. What does it say? Holy crap, hang on a second. Crap, I missed it. I gotta go see what's up. This is why. Oh, okay. Fire Dragon 1982, thank you so much for the $10 donation. Hope this helps buy more stuff. Thank you so much, sir or ma'am. I appreciate it greatly. Yeah, don't hurt Bert's feelings, man. He works hard for me, so I appreciate him. I take care of him. I maintenance him often. Don't worry. Bert will get the outer edges soon. It's just, it takes some time for the dough and the water to really get in there and mix everything up, so once it gets there, it turns into a really fine ball of dough. I'm just kidding, I love you, 09. 09, excuse me, underscore, thank you for being here, I appreciate it. I know sometimes the sound, or even the way Bert mixes stuff is annoying, but I promise you, down the line, he's gonna have some really awesome stuff. I have a KitchenAid, not the boss one like you do, but it does take a while for it to get everything. It does. Stick your hand in there. No. You stick the hand in there. I'll let you do it. Alrighty, so it's gonna start to mix everything up. So once it gets it all in there and all the water is absorbed by all the flour, we're gonna get a nice dough ball formation happening, which is gonna be nice. I would cook more if I had a good blender like that. This is a really nice mixer. I really like this mixer. I thank my sun and stars that Tally is really in tune with what I like to get as gifts. So he got me this KitchenAid mixer for my birthday a couple years ago, and I've loved it ever since. You know, a lot of women get offended getting appliances. A lot of ladies in relationships sometimes get offended by getting appliances for gifts, but I'm the one that, I'm one of those that get excited about it. People kind of accuse me of setting women back because I do so much classic houseworking stuff, and I feel like I have to disagree. I work together as a team with Tally. We work together, and Tally treats me with mucho respect, and I appreciate that, and he appreciates me. So it's a nice, you know, balanced, you know, relationship that we have right now, which is nice. It's not going to be always perfect, but, you know, we work through it. We talk. I would love to get a stand mixer. These things are cool. Yeah, pretty much, it's a system, man. I cook and he eats it, it works out just fine. So now we have a really good dough ball forming right now, which is nice. I things. If you were pay attention carefully to prices online for Amazon, or you know, during Black Friday or during holiday events, holiday deal events, you're gonna see some really good stuff. I'm just hating because my wife doesn't cook for shit. It's okay. That's okay. That's the way it should be. You guys are awesome. Very glad to have gotten to know you guys at BlizzCon. Thank you. I'm glad that, Indy, I'm really glad that you're around again. I really am. I enjoy watching Indy grow on the streams. Because I don't play Hearthstone. I don't like Hearthstone, but I'll watch Indy play Hearthstone. Because her streaming presence is really nice. She's just starting out again after a long-ass hiatus. And I'm just really glad she's back, because I get to see her do her thing again, where before she's always done a good job, but sometimes life gets in the way. And so now she's like completely updated her streaming stuff. She's got new graphics. So we have a nice dough ball formation. I'm gonna hand mix the rest. So thank you, Bert, you did your job today. Appreciate it. This priests are a bitch to kill. Yes, Indy Garona plays World of Warcraft, or at least she did. Plays a disciplined priest. She does a really good job with that. Her whole overlay kind of design is based off of the Blood Elf priest, which is pretty cute as hell. So anyway, let me clean off the countertop really quick, and then we're gonna knead this dough by hand really quick. So anyway, I want to clean up the countertop really quick, dry it off, and then we're going to put some flour down. We're going to hand knead this mofo. Graphics done by Z Corona. So you guys go to Instagram, Z Corona. If you guys ever want to get your own streaming graphics, I recommend her. She did mine. She knew yours. I used to cook more than I had a baby, and I just eat what I can make. Eventually, she will get more independent. I miss cooking, so I have to resort to watching others cook. So thank you, Lula. Well, thank you, Trinky, for being here. Thank you for watching your asses, or thank you all for watching and, you know, helping me out here. It's pretty cool. Okay. There we go. Let's put some flour down. Alright, so this is kind of a dry dough, so I'm a little bit worried. So we're going to take away a little bit of the flour granules in the middle. And then we're going to start doing our mixing here. So if you kind of notice, the dough's still not really ready. There's still a lot of lumps in here, so we're going to try and work out those lumps. If not, we're going to let this sit for a little bit. I tried doing that 10-day lemon cleanse. I quit after 18 hours. Dang. I was going to try the lemon cleanse, and I decided not to because I really didn't want to go that long without eating, because I love food too much. So I just resorted to doing meal prep with Tally. I do meal prepping with Tally on the regular now. I have my share of chicken, brown rice, and vegetables all day, every day, except when I stream. When I stream cooking, I only stream it twice a week, so I only like really indulge twice a week, and the rest of the week isn't really that bad. So the gluten strands in here are really, really, really tight. So I'm gonna let this go for a minute. I'm just gonna cover it, let it relax for a minute or two. While that happens, I gotta get my pot of water boiling for a proofer. So this needs to rest for a second. I'm gonna let it rest. So let me do that. Really, let me let that rest really quick. The gluten strands are really tight there, so we just gotta really let it relax before we keep going. And seriously, like 5 to 10 minutes will help you out immensely if you are not getting that smooth dough. Also, I'm working on slowing down when I talk to kind of give better explanations. Like I said, I'm trying to export all my VODs to YouTube. I already started. I have a YouTube channel and everything. It's just, it's not a personalized YouTube channel. It's like youtube.com/insert random letters and numbers and symbols here. So I should get that link going. I don't have a lot of videos up yet. It's because I started the YouTube channel very, very recently, so it's still a lot of time before I can apply to get a personalized YouTube channel, I guess. Where did you get this cooking music? It is Jazz Bossa Nova on YouTube. So if you go to Jazz Bossa Nova Music and YouTube it, you get to have a really large selection of really nice, relaxing music. I try to, you know, put a nice underlying jazzy, but, you know, demure music so that we can have a very chill stream. I don't want high energy right now, I just want chill. All right, I just had to get some water. So, let me just make sure what I have to do with the rest of this. So I'm not gonna make one giant sourdough loaf anymore. I'm going to make like smaller loaves, basically smaller domes as dinner rolls, because it's gonna go as a complement to the beef stroganoff. So I'm gonna let that happen. Hang on 1 second, you guys. So let me get the other ingredients ready. Or I should say, actually, I gotta wash this. I'm trying to kill more time so that this sourdough ball has time to rest. So let me clean what I just used so I can use it again for the stroganoff. As soon as this thing is, as soon as the dough ball starts proofing, we're gonna work on the stroganoff. I'm also gonna reduce down the heat of, I'm gonna reduce the heat for the sourdough bread in the oven from 425 to like 375, just to kind of give it more of a low and slow baking. I think it could benefit from it. Oh, you found a YouTube channel. Nice. It just barely started. Thank you, Dark Guardian, for that. It just barely started, so I don't have a lot of videos up yet. And it turns out my introduction video can flag for copyright, so I can't upload like 20 of my VODs from Twitch, so that was a big boo, so that's why I don't have a lot of other videos up there. But starting from here on forward, I'm doing my best to remember to turn off my introduction music before I start cooking so I can use the rest of the music for background without getting copyright flagged. And I can actually put my VODs up on YouTube without a problem. So there's problems with YouTube right now, but I'm working on it. Oh, it has an, yeah, so there's an Oreo video from like 2010 on it? Wait, is it really still have the Oreo video in there? That's, I thought my channel didn't have that. That's weird. I only have 5 videos and it shouldn't have Oreo on there. Oh well. Oh, this is the wrong one. Oh no, this is the right one. Oh, this is not it. I gotta get rid of those. Not the right channel. Let me see if I can find it. Give me a second. I think I have it somewhere. I got this. Oh, this one's it. The other one is a kind of a failure. And here, this is the right one. There you go. That's the one. The old YouTube was better. Well, thank you. I loved the old YouTube as well. This is still tight. Hang on a second. I don't know what's wrong with you. Why are you so tight? Why are you so tight, bro? Why you have to be mad? It's only a game. Why you have to be mad? Okay, we're gonna go for it. My English is bad, but I like your channel. Well, thank you, Flormai, for sticking around. Thank you for being here and watching. I appreciate the compliment. So we are going to... Bye, Thor. Have a good day. Alrighty. So, if you guys don't know, Thor's a pretty awesome dude. So, Thor has, we've always met at BlizzCon. And, he's always been a really awesome dude. He's also obligatory, always first in line for the line to get into BlizzCon. He literally legit camps out overnight at the front of the line. He's always there with the chair, with it's just funny. It's awesome. So always, he's at the front of the line, and he's helped my sister out. He's helped my sister get in, so that I appreciate him greatly. Hello, Hydro Jack. How are you today? Alrighty, so we're done kneading. It's still not smooth. I don't know what's going on. I don't want to keep kneading it, though. The gluten strands keep ripping like crazy, and I'm not sure why. It's probably because it's still really tight. Oh, I'm just going to knead it one more time. Come on. Giving it a massage so it can relax. Okay, so we're just gonna let you get into a greased up bowl. Your nails are so shiny and nice, thank you. So Tally treated me to a mani pedi. So this is kind of a celebration for getting taxes done and stuff like that, and doing stuff like a boss. Getting shit done like a boss. So I had to take advantage, man. I was gonna use my nail wraps, but this is good for now. I get to save my nail wraps for when I do I want to save my nail wraps for like TwitchCon or, you know, PAX, because people will get it there. If I do this right now, no one's gonna see it, first of all. Well, you guys will see it, but I'm gonna wait on that. What's up, Zakatis? How are you today? Welcome. Alright, so I'm gonna take my nonstick spray. It's starting to run out. No! Oh wait, I have another one. Now I have an extra! Yay! There we go. What kind of nail wraps do you use? Trinky, a viewer sent me nail wraps from this company called Jamberry? Jamberry or something like that. So they're really nice. I really like them. God, this is too It was just a tiny touch bit too dry. Anyway, she managed to make custom-made nail wraps that actually have my logo on there. And there's purple, black, it's a black base with my logo on one nail, purple flames on the other nails, and Lulaboo Gaming on like another nail, so it's really cool. Oh, it might have been just as too dry. Hang on. I'm still getting it, dampening it up. I started playing WoW today for the first time since Burning Crusade. Holy crap. Be careful, man. I don't want to lose you. Oh yes, jamberries are so awesome. Yeah, I had a lady, I guess she's a jamberry consultant, hit me up for some nail wraps. Damn it. I keep getting sucked into those consultant thingies. Like a pantry chef. What is it? You know that they have the pantry chef, or what's it called again? Oh, what's that one that consulting thing on cooking? Is that the pantry chef? One of us. I thought Creative Channel was just drawing. This has really expanded so fast in a few months, right? I really appreciate the Twitch support for cooking channels. I think that's really, really awesome. Pampered Chef, thank you. Pampered Chef. I get sucked into like Pampered Chef, and I actually went to a Tupperware party one time. I also went to a party one time that was for ladies that was like adult themed. So I was like, wow, this is crazy. They have consultants for everything now. Oh, and like Mary Kay, and then there's like Cookie Lee. My mom was Cookie Lee for a while. She gave me all this jewelry. It was pretty cool. Alright, I can't need this anymore. I just have to let it go. I don't know what's going on with this thing, but hopefully it'll relax more after I proof it. Adult Tupperware? Shut up. No, well, yes. Let's just call it adult Tupperware. Alright, so, They have freaking consulting things for, like, everybody now. They have man cave ones now, where for men only, so it's like bratwurst, man cave items, recliners. It was weird. They get really competitive too. I've seen it. Alright, so I'm gonna put this in the bottom oven to proof. So sausage, yeah, yes, it was a sausage party. Yes, exactly. All right, so I'm gonna take the boiling water that I have, put it in the proofer. Put it in my bottom oven. And then we're gonna start working on our Alright, so I'm gonna let that sit in there for a good long time this time. What time is it? I just gotta make sure I can time my progress really quick. So it is 2:10, so around 2:40 I'll probably try and check into it. But for now, let's start doing our stroganoff. Okay, let me just clean off the counter. I made a mess. You got nice countertops. Thank you. I love my countertops. I try to take care of it. I got this new cleaner called Granite Gold that I use now. To every like other, every weekend, I kind of wipe everything down with Granite Gold. Because I really want to take care of these. I really like these. Come on. There we go. Alrighty, so what's the thing? I have to check my book really quick. Oh, here we go. Beef stroganoff. So we're going to need 3.5 tablespoons of butter, 1 tablespoon all-purpose flour, 1 cup of beef broth, 1 pound of beef tenderloin, which I did not use tenderloin, I substituted a different kind of beef, 2 tablespoons olive oil, 1/2 cup of thinly sliced shallots, 3/4 pound of mushrooms, 3 tablespoons of sour cream at room temperature, 2 tablespoons of dill, 1/2 teaspoon of salt, 1/4 teaspoon of pepper, and white egg noodles. Alrighty, so let's get our ingredients out. Wax on, wax off. Yes, exactly. So I like to make sure I have the ingredients ready before we do anything. So let me get a bunch of ingredients ready. So we're not scrambling later. I don't like surprises. I mean, I do, but 3.5 tablespoons. And then it says melt 1.5 tablespoons of butter. So we're gonna need 1.5 right now. So this is going on the stove, and then this is going on something else. I'm not sure what it is yet, but we're gonna leave those there for now. Twitch is derping out again? Are you serious right now?
Twitch growing pains, man. Twitch growing pains to the max.
Oh, I am missing an ingredient. Dill, I'm sorry. There is an ingredient I'm missing here. Hang on 1 second. So I'm trying a new website. I'm trying a new website right now for ingredients. The website's Epicurious. They have a lot of good ratings, so I decided to take a look at it. I figured I'd give it a shot. I've done Food Network so much, I figured I'd change it up. Somebody told me to look into it, so I did. So I am making a recipe off of the Epicurious website and see what happens. So I know I'm missing something here. 1 teaspoon Dijon mustard. That's what I thought. 1 teaspoon Dijon mustard. And this one I have horseradish Dijon mustard. So it's gonna be pretty legit. My following list just unpopulated and repopulated. Weird. That is weird. Alrighty, so let me make sure everything's kosher. Oh, I have to retweet this. Grats fail, Lula, on 20k Twitch followers. Oh my lord, yes. Yes. I'm just going to retweet what Indy put in here. Because why not? And then get back on the Twitch stream. Alright, cool. We're done with that. So let's get our 1 tablespoon AP flour. Measuring spoons. Oh wait, here it is. Got it. Ooh, thank you so much for the host. What is this? Hang on a second. DJ Striker 2, thank you so much for the host. I appreciate it greatly. Busty, hello, how are you today? Thanks for coming in. Welcome, welcome. Alrighty, so we have our flour right here. We need 1 cup of beef broth. Alrighty, beef broth. Where's my beef? I have beef broth. Alright, cool. I don't know why, but every time I went shopping for beef broth, I kept seeing beef flavored stock, beef flavored broth. And I thought that was kind of weird. And I was like at Savvy Food at the time. I'm like, oh, this is some knockoff ass shit. So I went to the really fancy, grocery store looking for regular beef broth. Apparently all the beef broth is beef flavored broth or stock. Oh, I guess I can put it right here. 1 cup. Alrighty, so is this 1 cup? Yes, it is. Yes, it is. Alright, so we have that. Let me start chopping up those mushrooms. We need mushrooms and shallots, and we need to cut the beef. So we're gonna cut the beef last, let's do the mushrooms and shallots now. Whoa! Whoa! Whoa, hang on. Whoa. Busty, BMH, thank you so much for subscribing to the channel. Welcome to the convoy, Mother Trucker. Toot toot! Thank you so much for the support. I appreciate it greatly. Thank you, thank you. Come on in, everybody. Let's celebrate. We got a new subscriber today. We officially hit 80 subscribers. 20 subs away before Tally has to get on my stream and cook a dish with me. So we are ever so closer. Alrighty, so this is a 4 cup measuring cup. It measures all the way to the 4 cup line, which is pretty legit. I only need 1 cup, and it's quite a large measuring cup, so I always have to measure in large volumes, especially when I'm cooking with a lot of people. So I ended up getting this 4 cup measuring cup, and it's helped me out really. It's super. I love this thing, it's so awesome. So we're gonna work with the mushrooms first, we're gonna chop those up first, then we're gonna chop up the shallots because of the onion flavor, and then we're gonna chop up the beef because of sanitation issues, so beef last. What kind of measuring cup is that? Also, hi everybody, what's up Rolling Thunder, how you doing? I wish I could sub for just Tally Lula cooking stream. Hopefully soon. Hey man, we're gonna have a Tally Lula cooking stream soon, if this keeps going the way it is. Thank you so much everybody, doing the supportages. Pretty awesome. So I'm going to have to peel down this shallot. You heard her, go grab your friends and make them subs so you can have Tally cook with her. It'll be epic. I'm doing great. How about you, Lula? I'm doing pretty good. It's a nice chill day for me today. I'm really just kind of relaxed. I had a really relaxing weekend, so now I'm just really relaxing now. I haven't gotten out of the relaxation mode quite yet. And that is okay. I still haven't knocked out of relaxation mode, which is great. That's always what you want to shoot for when you go on vacation. Or when you take some time off. You're hoping that some of that, you know, de-stress just kind of follows you back and you go back to doing what you're doing and normally. And it has, and I appreciate it a lot. So it looks like we're probably just gonna just mince this whole shallot. Let's mince the whole shallot. Okay, so there we go. Don't do what I'm doing right now, it's pretty dangerous, but it's a shallot, so I'm not expecting too much danger, but there we go. Oop, oop, oop. Whoops. So we're going to... So shallots are a lot more milder in flavor than onions, so they're really nice for someone who doesn't like onions like Tally. I kind of use them so that they, don't give out that heavy flavor, except that they're still making my eyes bleed! Why? I mean, not bleed, but they're making me cry still. You can't see me, but I got tears running down my face. Okay, so I'm gonna chop that up. So this still has enough potency to make me start tearing up. Great. Thanks. So we're trying to use every facet of this shallot, and we're just gonna just leave out the nub at the end. Oh my god, my eyes. Ah! Oh my god, now I can't see. I can't see. All right, so let me just do a quick chop up on this just to make sure we got everything. And then I'm trying, I can't see anything. I can't even see chat right now. I can just see like globule shapes of my, the shape, general shape of my pile of shallots, and that's about it. Switch that up. There we go. Oh, why does it affect me so? Oh my lord, my eyes are crazy. What's up, Shantron Gaming? How are you today? It seems like I always come in when you're cutting onions. Or they're cousins. Yeah, right? My eyes, they burn. I have to be very careful right now. Oh, hang on a second, you guys. Oh, I'm gonna get my safety goggles. Hang on a second. My safety goggles are still here from when I did the dry ice cream thing, so I'm gonna put those on right now and continue. Oh, wow, that made a big old difference. Wow, I need to wear these. These are now officially my onion goggles. Oh my god, this is amazing. This is great! Oh my god, yes. Oh my god, yes. Guys, we just found a solution. Oh my god, this is great. It doesn't get everything, but it's definitely minimized it to a very low tolerable levels. So yay for that. Okay. Anyway, these are my safety goggles when I was still a microbiology major in college. And I decided I liked cooking better, so I switched majors. I have a certification. I'm certified to work like grunt work at a laboratory right now, but that's about it. I'm not a scientist. Maybe one day I'll go back and complete my biology degree. Biology, emphasis in cell microbiology. Cell molecular biology, excuse me. Alrighty, so we have our shallots, yay. Alrighty. Alright, so shallots are done. I was supposed to do the mushrooms first, but I didn't. I'm dumb. So we're gonna need 3/4 of a pound of mushrooms. One of these packages is 8 ounces, which is 1/2 pound. So that means we're only gonna need 1/2 of this package after that. So thing about mushrooms is that you have to clean them, but you can't run them through water. You have to take a damp paper towel and just kind of wipe them down. Oh! A shallot was worse than like a regular onion, I swear. What's up, Carnassus? How are you today? So I'm just wiping down my mushrooms. Are you still streaming from a laptop? I need to figure out what I need to get for both streaming and for my boat for a beer stream. Hell yeah, you should do a homebrewing. That would be amazing. Homebrewing stream would be legit. Yeah, I'm still streaming from a laptop. The Origin PC laptop that Tally got from Origin PC. I totally stole it and it is mine now. I would love to watch Carnassus homebrew. So anyway, I have a 15-foot USB cable connecting my my Razer Siren microphone and my C920 Logitech. So that's how I managed to get everything far away. Leave everything on the laptop. So if you can manage to find really long USB cables, Jeff, that will work too. You don't really need much to stream from a laptop if you're only doing homebrewing. If you're not doing anything crazy intensive like World of Warcraft, or if you're not doing any game capturing or game streaming while you're doing your homebrewing, then you're not going to need that too much of a powerful laptop. You're only going to be worried more about the internet connection. You got to make sure you have a really solid internet connection. More than anything, if you're just doing, if you're only streaming with a camera capture, which does not even require a capture card. So, it's good. Very low resources for a cooking stream. Go. We're almost done. I'm like still getting like the legit runny nose left over from this business I have. Okay, so it's okay if we beat up the mushrooms a little bit. It's fine. The onions gave me a runny nose, I swear. Alright, so just finish cleaning up everything. So let us chop this up into oblivion. Actually, we don't have to chop them up into oblivion. We just have to slice them into their mushroom cross sections. And that's about it. We don't need to, like, stroganoff, you kind of want to show off the mushrooms, so we're not going to get too crazy chompy. We just got to get this shape. I'm going to keep them in this shape so you can kind of see it while we're still doing the stroganoff, which is fine. You just cut them across at one side, and that is it. If you guys have any questions about anything that I'm doing, let me know so I can let you guys if I can answer any questions you might have. If you are new to cooking or just new to this stream, I'm here, happy to answer some questions for you guys while I'm doing this. I'm just sitting here explaining away my methods here. Has anybody... Crap, hang on a second. Oh yes, tomorrow, you guys, tune in, I'm going to be making pasta from scratch. I'm going to try to make pasta from scratch. The stupid pasta roller still has not showed up, so I'm still waiting for the pasta roller to come into the mail from Amazon so I can actually start making pasta. Otherwise, I'm going to have to do a backup somehow of something. I have the same cutting board. Nice! I love this cutting board. This is my favorite cutting board. But anyway, yeah, no pasta roller yet, so I'm a little worried about tomorrow's stream. Hopefully it shows up today or at least tomorrow morning. That would be great. I mean, I'll still make pasta tomorrow, but I'm just gonna have to change it into like ravioli, I guess. With a cream sauce, white wine cream sauce or something. I think this one is gonna have to happen as a backup. Because you can still make pasta without a pasta roller. You can just roll it out into those sheets, take a ravioli cutter, which I have, make ravioli. There we go. How does a young pup like myself find a nice woman like you to cook for him? I don't know. Even if you don't, like, you want to find a woman or somebody in your life who compliments you, and whether or not they happen to cook or not, I mean, it's a nice plus for people. Some people don't care if they don't know how to cook. But what you can do, which is a nice couples building, what is it? Couples exercises in working together, is go to a cooking classes together. you guys are open to like learning how to cook together, there's like couples cooking classes that you can go. You spend time with each other. You guys learn stuff. You get to learn new stuff. It's nice. I kind of want to go to a cooking class here. Tally's not down for it though. I'm breaking his will down. We're gonna go eventually. I'm wearing his will down. Cook for yourself. Yes, absolutely. Cook for yourself. Cook for yourself. That's yes. Cook for yourself. But it's always a good idea, if you both don't really have too much of cooking experience, to just learn how to cook together. It gives you guys something to kind of bond with and spend time together with. It's always nice, you know, to have hobbies with, as a couple. So now Rob and I have hobbies together, like comic books and beer. So I'm just getting a new paper towel so I can wipe down the rest of these mushrooms. These are a lot of mushrooms. It'll be great practice for him, Lula. Know when he has to cook live. Yeah, that'd be cool. I only like cooking big family meals. I don't cook for myself. That's pretty cool too. A lot of people, I noticed though, there are some people who just only love to cook for big events or nothing at all. And that's, there's nothing wrong with that. What's up, honey? Almost done with the mushrooms, and then we're gonna work on our beef. Like I said, I did not get beef tenderloin. First of all, it was really expensive at the store. Second of all, I found a nice alternative. I didn't feel like breaking down a whole tenderloin, so I just got something that was already in slices, and I was just gonna cut it down farther from there. Yeah, I'm one of them. I live by myself and I don't make food unless it's something interesting. Yeah, I kind of like to cook for other people. I like to see their reactions. I always like to make people happy with food. It's kind of why I got into cooking in the first place, is that I just, you know, who doesn't like food? I always just like to try and make people happy with food. People, you know, food and good time go hand in hand most of the time, so you know, why not? Time check, what time is it? It is 2:34, so in 6 minutes we're gonna check up on our starter, our sourdough bread, see how it's going. Tally eating good tonight. I don't know if Tally's gonna eat this. It's kind of carby. He'll take a couple of bites, I think, and I think that's good. He's got a meal prep. Like, he's already got dinner for tonight, but he's definitely gonna have the Tally taste test for us, hopefully, and see if he likes it, at least. So let me just finish this up. This up. I don't want to interfere with Tally's meal prep planning thing because, you know, he's doing such a good job right now in his weight loss, and, you know, the meal prep has a lot to do with it. We keep getting told by a lot of fitness professionals, especially the ones that he watches on YouTube, that it really is, weight loss, it really is 80% diet and then 20%, you know, working out. They go hand in hand, but you really can't do the exercise and expect results without doing the nutritional part of it as well. Isn't that right, honey?
Yeah.
Tally agrees. If doesn't Tally doesn't touch it, then who eats this all this delicious food that you cook? I eat some of it. I give it away. I got, you know, I got options. Don't worry. For me, I don't eat it all at once in one day. I'll, you know, moderation, y'all. I can still eat the kind of food that I ate today, but I'm not gonna eat the whole thing today. I'm gonna, you know, leave some for the rest of the week, you know, have leftovers for the whole week, and then just take it apart little by little so I don't eat it all at once and blow my calorie count, because that would suck. So let me move this butter. It's in the way. Thanks, Sammy. Oh. Have fun at the gym. So Tally's going to the gym. Hopefully we'll have dinner ready by the time he gets back. Who knows? We'll have to find out. Seeing stuff get chopped is very satisfying. Lula, did you ever try that recipe I sent you a little while back with a pretzel crusted chicken with a mustard cream sauce? I am actually going to make pretzels on the stream first, and then I'm going to save some leftover to try that encrusting thing that you were sending me. Alrighty, so what's left is the steak. So I'm going to move these out of the way. So like I said, I ended up getting beef chuck, tender boneless beef chuck, because it's already in strips and I just didn't feel like breaking the whole tenderloin down, and this is a nice alternative. It was relatively inexpensive, so I, you know, went for this instead. Who, really, man, who can just go out to the store and just buy tenderloin all willy-nilly? Really? So we're gonna, they're already stripped out, we just gotta cut them into like 1 inch long piece, or 1 inch, into slices, into stroganoff slices. It'll be fun. Ooh, I love beef tongue, it's so good. Beef tongue is delish. You can never have too much beef, I think. And let me get a ready plate for this. I should say a ready bowl. Thank you so much for the host, Jagmas. You're amazing as usual. Thanks for the host, buddy. Appreciate it. Guys, follow Jagmas' channel. He always hosting me, man. He needs a hookup. Dude, that dude, no joke, always hosts me. I gotta give him a shout out, you know? Alright, so we got the strips. Cut into strips, and we're gonna make them a little kind of longish strips. They're gonna shrink when we cook them, so I'm not gonna make them too short. My dog is allergic to beef, yikes. I had a friend of mine that I worked with at Costco who's allergic to beef. Kinda sucks, I always have to remember that every time we go out and get food to go for everybody. Right, so that's done. I felt really sad for my friend, because it's like, beef was awesome, and she's like, yeah, I thought beef was awesome too until it tried to kill me. I'm like, yikes. Alrighty, so we're just gonna go in two strips, nice 2-inch strips, and then we're gonna go a couple inches down, thick. Alrighty, so we're gonna do this fairly quickly. Don't get too caught up on how long the strips are. You just, you know, it's gonna taste good no matter what. Don't worry too hard about how much to cut this or how to cut this or whatever. Oh yes, the Tally meal prep is on my YouTube, which I have finally the link for, so What could you use instead of beef if you're cooking for a vegetarian? Tofu. Tofu is probably a really good alternative. If you are cooking for a vegetarian, might I recommend Fake Gamer Girl on Twitch, twitch.tv/fakegamergirl. She does vegan cooking streams on the regular. So if you want to go over there, you can get your ass some really good tips about vegan cooking because, or vegetarian cooking because I have no insight to vegetarian cooking. I am a strict meatitarian, and so I cannot tell you a really good effective way to cook for a vegetarian. Alright, so portobello mushrooms. Actually, portobello mushrooms give that nice meaty texture. It's so weird. It's hard to explain, but I grilled a portobello mushroom once. I put salt, pepper, olive oil, threw it on the grill, cooked out all the water to it, and then when I took a bite, it actually had a really meaty texture. It's so good. I would just overload on portobello mushrooms, and I think you got it. Lula, what's the name of your YouTube channel? I don't have the name. Hang on a second. I just have the link because it's just a string of letters and numbers. So here it is. Alrighty, so there we go. Excellent. Thank you. You are welcome. So I have Tally's meal prep on there. I also have some recent videos. I also have my chicken fabrication video on there, so yay. So if you guys want to follow me on YouTube, I'll eventually start putting more videos. I cannot put some of my backlogged videos because apparently my introduction music has copyright on it, so I cannot use any of my introduction music, and my VODs are like covered in it, so I'm trying to be more careful in the future to not to have it around, not to have that intro music around when I start actually cooking, so that I can actually edit it out and put it on the YouTube channel. I love watching meal prep videos. Lula, were you chef before Twitch? I went to, well, sort of. I went to culinary school, started working in the culinary field. I worked at the Scratch Bakery at San Diego State University for a couple months. Found out that I have tendonitis from 10 years at Costco being a cashier. And couldn't hang. I can't hold a knife for longer than 30 minutes without intense pain. So that kind of sucks. But I learned a lot while I was there. Have you thought about making like a proper cooking show on YouTube? I would be down to help you with all that video assets and what you need for it. I can't even, like, okay, so when I was at the bakery at San Diego State University, we had to make, like, dinner rolls and breads for the cafeteria, for the sandwich places next door to the cafeteria. Like, a lot of places just need a lot of stuff. We made the bakery stuff for Starbucks. So it was this big old thing where I got to learn a lot of stuff. And anyway, I was sitting there and it was time to like make pizza dough for the pizza place on campus. So we were sitting there just rolling out dough for pizzas. I believe we did close to like 100 pizza shells or pizza doughs a day. And then over 1,000 dinner rolls for the campus cafeteria. So me sitting there doing this all day and then using dinner, you know, rolling out dinner rolls, my hands couldn't handle it. I couldn't hang. It sucked, but Tally got my back. He's like, that's okay. Just cook for me at home. And I was like, okay. One second, you guys. Thank you. What's up, Rathamom? How are you today? I thought about making a proper YouTube channel, but I really don't have time to really make a good one lately, especially since I run a lot of accounting and background for Tally Gaming. Because of the Tally Gaming thing, I have to make sure that that's number one. Because let's be real here, that's what pays the bills. This exactly doesn't pay the bills, but it gives, you know, it gives like beer money. So yeah, I get to like enjoy my beers. And I get to buy stuff for the stream with my money that comes in for the stream. So that's kind of nice. But ultimately, I'm going to be doing Tally Stream numero uno because that's what pays the electric bill. Dough's looking pretty swanky. I'm actually gonna let this go a little bit longer, to be honest. I really want that to be proofed, so we're gonna leave it there for a little bit longer and continue with the stroganoff. Lula, are you from New Jersey as well? No. No. No, I'm from Southern California. Alrighty. I am well. I hope you can say the same. I love your nails. Looks professional. Thank you. I love my nails too. I just recently got them done because Tally treated me to... Yeah. He's like, yeah, you just... Told him, what am I... On Sunday, he's like, what are you doing? I'm like, I don't know. I'm just hanging out. I'm gonna play video games. He's like, why don't you just go out, treat yourself, get stuff done. I'm like, okay. So I went and got a like full-on freaking mani-pedi because I deserve it. Alright, so... Here we go. Let's get started with the stove cam. We're gonna move on. What do I need to do here? Do I need... Oh, I need dill. So let me chop up some dill really quick and then we'll be continuing on to the cooking. Whoa! Shirin82, thank you so much for being subscribed for 5 months in a row. Thank you, Shirin, for the support. I appreciate it greatly. Another wonderful mod in our midst. Hello. Thank you, Shirin. What up, buddy? Whoop whoop. Okie dokie. So we're gonna chop the liver living crap out of this dill. Get rid of some of these stems though. There's a couple of stems in here. Nobody likes stems in their leaves. Sorry. Making my black bean brownies for the month. Hell yeah, you were telling me about those black bean brownies. Yo, Sharon, check your Discord. I don't know if you replied or not, but I haven't been on Discord yet since yesterday. But if you can check it out for me, that'd be great. So dill apparently is part of beef stroganoff, at least for the recipe that I was looking at, so I'm just gonna chop that up really quick. Please excuse me while I just sit here and try not to fall asleep to this relaxing stream. That is okay, man. As long as you leave your browser open, I'm cool with it. Oh, that's just me being unscrupulous right now. Excuse me. Alright, so we just chop that up nice and fine. Alrighty, so we're done with this. This is about 2 tablespoons of dill. Alrighty, so put this in here. Boom. I only use dill with fish. Don't know why. Because dill, it tastes amazing with fish. Why not? It's a good idea. Alrighty, so we have all of our ingredients. Yay. We're done using the cutting board for the day. Yay. Boop. Put it on potatoes that you're roasting. It's yummy.
Oh my god, it is. Dill potatoes are so good.
Oh, I should probably start boiling a pot of water for the egg noodles too, right? Right. Let's get started on some egg noodle action here. Might as well, right? Lulaboo saw the message and it's a yes. Whoop! Alright, thanks. Shern. Trying to fix this here really quick. Alrighty, so first thing we gotta do, I have everything I need for the beef stroganoff. Melt 1.5 tablespoons of butter in a saucepan. Okay, whisk in the flour for a roux. Okay, cool. Now we add the broth and we bring it to a boil and put it down to a simmer. Once it's done, keep it warm and then bust out the 12-inch skillet. All right, let's do that. Why am I watching this? Because it's amazing. Well, I don't know why, but thanks for being here. Boom. All right, so I'm gonna fill up a pot of water to start boiling off our egg noodles. Muy importante. Stove cam, what's up, Arcceptor?
Give me 1 second, you guys.
While for the water to hit a boil, so I'm gonna let that go for a while and also add some salt. So just so you guys can see what I'm doing, you know. So I'm salting up the water. I'm also gonna hit it with some olive oil so that the noodles don't stick. And then I'm just gonna let it boil. I don't need the 12-inch pot yet. So I'm waiting for the butter to melt and then we're gonna add in our flour. We're gonna make a roux. We're gonna let the flour and the butter cook out the flour flavor. Those are some nice pans. Give me a link, I'll order some. It is the Calphalon stainless steel pot and pan set. I recommend if you are just starting out cooking to go for the non-stick set because it makes your life way easier. Stainless steel, if you burn stainless steel, you're pretty much going to be scrubbing for a couple of hours. Alright, so here's our 1 tablespoon of butter going in. Julia Child would be proud of that butter. Yeah, buddy. Alright, so we put in our flour, so we're making a nice roux here. And we're gonna let the flour flavor cook out for a few minutes, a minute or two. We're trying to heat just slightly up. Alrighty, so we're gonna let that flavor cook out a little bit, and we're gonna add our beef stock to it. That is a beautiful stovetop. Thank you. I really love this stovetop. This is an amazing stovetop. I love my stovetop. I take care of it every day. Alrighty. So, let's see here. Add broth, bring to a boil, and then down to a simmer for a few minutes, and then keep warm. And then we're gonna season the beef with salt and pepper. We're going to add 1 tablespoon of butter plus 1 tablespoon of olive oil on our 12-inch skillet, and we're going to sear the beef, and then take the beef out of the pot. And then we're going to saute the shallots, saute the mushrooms, and then we're going to add in our meat into that big old pan. Ooh, lots to do. Oh, this water in the back needs to boil like crazy right now. Alright, and this needs to cook a little bit faster. We just need to get the flour flavor out of this roux, and that's about it. And I think we're there. If you cook the roux lightly and it only has a slightly brown flavor, it's going to be a blonde roux. It's going to be very light in flavor. The longer you cook down your roux and gets darker, and it develops a more nuttier flavor. So it will affect your end product. We're only going for a blonde roux right now, so we're going to leave it there. We're just going to whisk in our broth here. There we go. So we're going to whisk that in. It's got to hit a boil, so let's let it hit a boil. Turn up the temperature. Put the last of that beef juice in there. So this is going to be the base sauce that's going to go on top of our egg noodles. I'm just trying to whisk out all the flour lumps in case we have any. It's always a good idea. I'm using my silicone whisk because it can handle some higher temperatures, and it will not scratch up my stainless steel. This is one of my favorite whisks right now. I really like it. Alright, so pretty sure that does not have any lumps in there. So we're just gonna let it sit there. Once it hits the boil, we're gonna put the temperature down to a simmer. Let it cook out for a few minutes, and we're going to move on to the next step. So while I'm waiting for this to hit a boil, let me check up on that sourdough. What time is it? I need a time check. Yeah, it's time. It's been 40 minutes that the sourdough has been proofing. I'm letting it go proof a little bit longer because of issues, so I just want to make sure that it's actually proofing well. Lula, while I was watching Tally's meal prep video, I noticed you used parchment paper instead of aluminum foil. Is there any reason you chose parchment paper? I'm always partial to parchment paper because it will never, ever stick to my pan. Chicken will never stick to, like, no food will stick to parchment paper after it's been baked. Bread won't stick to parchment paper. Everything does not stick to parchment paper. I do not use aluminum foil because I always have to unstuck it from the pan, unstuck the food from the foil. It's just a big old hassle for me. So for me, it's always been parchment all the way. Thank you, Zed, for being here. Have a good night. Not gonna lie, digging the music, super chill. Thank you. Tally's meal prep would make me fart, all the broccoli. I use a bag of mixed vegetables because I like broccoli, but I don't want to keep using it. Tally keeps saying that broccoli has, like, anti-estrogen, helps lower the estrogen levels, raise your testosterone, and I'm like, I do not need that. As a woman, that is exactly the opposite of what I need, so I do mixed vegetables.
Pretty much.
Okay, so it looks like the sourdough's done proofing. Yikes. We cooked a lot of freaking broccoli that day for the meal prep video. So let me switch back over to the sourdough. Okie dokie. So we're gonna let the beef broth simmer on a very, very, very low heat. while I do this. This is our sourdough bread. Obviously, it has doubled in size, and I let it go for a little, for a good long time. So we're gonna punch down our bread, or punch down our dough. And we're gonna have to shape this dough when we're done. It's definitely very relaxed. I can definitely knead the crap out of this, and we can get a nice, finally smooth dough on the top, which is what I've always been going for. Just could not achieve at the beginning of the stream, which kind of sucked. It's okay. Just not coming together. Why are you still apart? Just gotta knead this into submission really quick. The dough's not fusing together, which is weird. Okay, so we gotta measure out this dough. Okay, so let me measure out this dough. We're gonna go and we're gonna cut out 1 inch, 1 ounce portions of our dough. So let me put this plastic on here. I forgot which side was in. There we go. We'll just put plastic here. And I'm gonna get my dough cutter really quick. Alrighty, I've been strongly thinking of switching from aluminum foil to parchment paper for baking chicken breasts, but was skeptical of the coating of the paper. It will work. I love parchment. I do not have a hassle with parchment, so it's kind of nice. 1.5 ounces is what I'm going for dough. That's not, oh yeah, that's. 1.5 ounces. Good enough. This is 2.4, not it. This is it right here. We're just portioning out our dinner roll size stuff, hopefully. They might be kind of large dinner rolls, but we're gonna go with it anyway. Fine. It's 1.8, not good. 1.7, Lord. Okay, so it's 1.5 right here. Boom. 1.5 ounces all day. And it's, I don't know, it's weird. I'm concerned the dough's not fusing together. This work. I'm having a problem with sourdough and I'm not sure why. Why you fuck with me, sourdough? Why you fuck with me? Okay. So I should probably get a parchment paper ready for all of this dough. And I'm gonna shape and then throw onto parchment paper. We're gonna proof it, which means I have to boil more fucking water, and I didn't. Go me. Don't fuck the streamer sourdough. I know, I'm trying not to. It's not working. I'm getting some bad juju right now with some bread making. Bad juju is no juju, no good juju. Alrighty, so that's 1.1. There we go. Is this? Yeah, that's a dinner roll. this too much. Oh, perfect. All right, so we're almost there. That's it too. That is not big enough. All right, so I'm gonna turn off the stove with the beef broth stuff on it because I don't want it to go over, evaporate, and then we have no sauce product. So in a few minutes, I'm going to turn that off. What's this? 1.8, definitely can cut that down. One point six, perfect. All right, so let's get this out of the way. You got a shaper dough. You got to put it on parchment. So let me go grab the parchment. Not even. I can use a silk mat. Yay, silk mat! I cleaned them and everything. I can just use a silk mat. Fuck yes. All right, so we are going to shape these rolls into dough balls. So I'm just going to mix these together. And like I said, we're gonna roll those dinner roll size shapes. I'm gonna get them nice and tight. Doit, like a doiger. I'm gonna get that nice little twist in the inside. That's how you know you got a good dinner roll thing going on. To get these all nice and tight, so I'm gonna be doing this for a while. Bam. Oop. And you wanna leave room for them to like get bigger. I feel like I'm in my mom's kitchen. Yeah. Baking takes a little longer than the grill, but God, the cleanup is nothing. Yeah, I know, right? I used my George Foreman grill quite a bit. It came with a little cleaner thingy that made cleaning it pretty easy, so I'm confused by all the people saying it's hard. Maybe I got a newer version? Hang on a second. It's okay. So I'm basically what I'm doing, and I gotta show you guys, it's time to dry up here, so I'm trying to like work the dough a little bit so they don't dry up. I don't want these guys to dry up. You can cover these with a damp paper towel or cloth so that they don't get as dry. But I'm hoping I can just knock these out a little bit. So I'm gonna start going double time here. Hang on. Lula, the nails look amazing today. Thank you, Sully. Fissel. Boom. Gonna finish that off on this side. I feel like I'm just like, I don't know, wiping a pair of tits sometimes when I do this. I haven't done rolling with the left hand in a while, so it's going to take some practice for me to get the left-handed going correctly. This one, not good enough. I mean, I got it started, it's just not good. One still not great. Boob massages. Yeah, it looks like I'm doing boob massages, I swear. Alrighty. Come on. I haven't practiced dinner roll making in a while, so this is going a little bit crazy. Alrighty, so this is done. Put it off to the side. Oh, I approved it. I'm gonna start boiling my water again. So the meat juice thing is just gonna sit for a while. I'm actually gonna whisk that up, so that's skin right there for me. I'm gonna
get rid of that skin, let it stay warm in the back burner, and then we're gonna move on. See, look at that, nice and smooth now. Yay. And that is the basis of our stroganoff sauce. That right there was the basis for our stroganoff sauce, so, you know, we know where we're going with that.
Okay. Lula, I swear I got the best ingredient to add to all your recipes, beer. That is a good ingredient to add to all your recipes, actually. So, give me a second. So I'm using the outside edges of my hand. All this right here is what I'm using to roll my dough. And I'm kind of using the inside, I'm cupping the inside, forcing pressure on the outside of my hand, and then just kind of to force everything going to the inside. What's up, Who Loves Waffles? Whoa, Nigga Sammy, thank you so much for subscribing for 5 months in a row. I appreciate the support. Thank you. 5 months sub. Almost missed it. I'm sorry. Nice. A nice tight circle in there. It always helps. Okay, so I'm like doing titty rubs right now. Practicing titty rubs. Next time I go to the strip club. Be nice. Oh, come on. Ugh. Alrighty, so we have a rolling foil right now. Oh, much better. Oh my god, this is so much better. It's marginally better. It's still got a lot of flour on there. Alrighty, so the pot of boiling water for the oh my lord, come on. Don't stick, stop sticking. Egg noodle water is ready. So I'm throwing egg noodles into my pot of boiling water here. I'm not using the whole thing because I'm not going to eat the whole thing. And then we're going to set a timer. So directions on the bag say how many minutes to boil? Eight to 9 minutes. So we're gonna go with the safe bet and go 8 minutes. Setting a timer for 8 minutes. While that cooks. Alrighty, it's not working. I have to go back down to down here. And that's fine. Here goes. Taking a little longer than I want. Can I have to knead your sourdough a little bit? Before you start rolling, so you have that nice damp outside before you start rolling. I have to knead this down a little bit. Why don't you put flour on the counter? Because it doesn't give me the resistance I need to actually shape this into a dinner roll shape. If I put flour down, it doesn't stick to, it doesn't have resistance against the granite, and then I won't be able to roll into dinner roll shape and get that desired, you know, shape at the bottom and smoothness on top. That dank outside, yo, before you start rolling, that's right. I gotta like dampen my hands a little bit. My hands are not wet, they're just damp. Just enough to kind of re-wet the outside because sometimes it can just get a little too dry on the outside. You want your dough to get a little bit sticky so you can get that resistance on the countertop, and it helps. Boop. So I do not have a sheet for the rest of these, so I'm going to knead this back together. I don't need that many dinner rolls. I think 12 is enough for me and Tally, so I'm going to put this back together, put it in the freezer, and we'll save it for another day. Alrighty, here we go. Alrighty. So, I'm gonna put this in a Ziploc and we're gonna put it back in the freezer. In the cooker, and the water's boiling in the stove. I can put it back in the oven. Yay! Alrighty, so I just turned on the oven so we can get it ready to start doing more stuff. Oh God, get away. Stupid fly. Alrighty. Okie dokie, so I stirred up the pasta so that it wouldn't stick together. Let us continue on forward with our recipe. So, let's melt 1 tablespoon of butter and 1 tablespoon of olive oil in the skillet. 12-inch skillet. So low heat first so we can at least just start melting the butter because it's all we need right now. I live off burgers, don't we all? Don't we all? Tablespoon olive oil. Okay. So we're going to be searing our beef here. So before we sear our beef, let's season the beef. So this kind of going in here. We're going to mix it all together eventually, don't worry. And we're using pepper to grind that up too. We'll put that right here. You guys can see this, right? Yeah, you can kind of see it. It's fine. Salt and pepper, always the best if you're looking for just standard seasoning. Salt and pepper has always been the standard seasoning since forever. It's not necessarily what you have to do, but you know, it's what the recipe calls for the beef stroganoff. So we're gonna definitely try and go for it. Cause why not? A little bit more salt, a little bit more pepper, do some more turning on it. Turn. Okay. More pepper because I like pepper. So we're going to wait for the pan to get nice and warm because I want a nice sizzle when the beef starts cooking. So we're turning up the heat now that it's pretty much melted. Ooh, I gotta get rid of that little piece of paper. There we go. I love barbecue, oh my lord. The seasoning has not touched all the pieces of beef, unfortunately. It's okay. Come on. This is gonna be the next big thing. Get away with CSGO. Oh my lord. You guys are funny. Unfortunately, because the butter has such a low smoke point, I have to start putting in some food right now so it doesn't smoke up the pan too much. I want to food Twitch all my life. I love food too, that's why I'm doing this. Nope, 8 minutes is over. Okay, so I have to hurry this up. We're gonna do this in two phases, so we're in first phase. Phase one. Strogonoff boss fight, phase one. Alright, yes, I heard you, thank you. Alright, so gloves. Strainer, gloves, ready. Alright, so we're gonna put the egg noodles back in the big dish, and we're gonna add some butter in there. Actually, not butter, olive oil, so that it doesn't stick together. So the butter noodles will stick together. I'm just throwing in a little bit of olive oil and then top it. Oh my god, shut up. Alrighty. So we're just trying to get some brown color on our beef. We're not trying to cook it all the way. I guess we should cook it all the way. Actually, I just really want to get a nice browning on our pan here. Legit. Too legit to quit. Alright, so let's turn up the heat now. I'm gonna add some more salt in here, just because I'm a salt-heavy person. So I will always go for the little saltier taste in here, just because I can. I'm trying to turn over most of the red meats, meats that are still looking red, so we can cook both sides and have it all nice and even. Just a little bit more olive oil here. Oh, I gotta put a landing pad for this beef once it's done cooking. go. Getting a nice brown in here, which is nice. I like the long cooked beefs and meats. I agree, me too. A nice, you know, crock pot pot roast, or a nice crock pot roast in general. Oh, it's so good. Oh, it's so good. There we go. I am a fan of using my crock pot. I gave it to my mom, so I don't have it right now. But whenever I get the chance, I always like to crock pot a nice, you know, roast, chuck roast, or a tenderloin, or a butt roast. So good, so good. I just cover it in all the good things, add a splash of wine in there, you know, a nice acid, help tenderize the beef while it's doing the lowest slow cooking anyway. Or apple cider vinegar. I'm a huge fan of using apple cider vinegar when I cook meats. Always a fan. If you do not want to use alcohol as an acid to throw into food, you can always use apple cider vinegar, red wine vinegar, white wine vinegar. There are so many options. Dang, I love cooking. Me too. I love cooking too. Let's be friends. Trying to drain out some of the meat juice here. We need to keep the meat juice. Oh my god, we gotta separate out some of these meat pieces here. And you know what, I'll put salt while it's cooking. I know it draws out some of the moisture, but I think it's okay. I think I will live with that. And that is okay with me. There, you know, what's nice about cooking is that you can do whatever the hell you want. Whatever method works best. Oh my god, we gotta separate out some of these meat pieces here. And you know what, I'll put salt while it's cooking. I know it draws out some of the moisture, but I think it's okay. I think I will live with that. And that is okay with me. There, you know, what's nice about cooking is that you can do whatever the hell you want. Whatever method works best for you, you can do it on your own stove, in your own home. And get to do it your way. Cook food exactly the way you like it, so you can just satisfy yourself in all the right places, all the right ways, I guess you could say. Wow, freezing. Lula, you need to shut up about that freezing. I don't know until it comes out of my mouth. Put a cover on the pot. Don't tell me what to do. I'm just kidding. Alrighty. So toss this around. I wouldn't worry. Don't worry about it. I got this. Cooking it for a long period of time will make this happen as well, so, or will make it tough as well. So we're just gonna cook it till it is no longer pink in the middle, or on the outside, I should say, and that's about it. If we cook it longer, it's gonna start getting leathery and dry, and it's no bueno. Lula, what beer would you drink with this? With a stroganoff? Probably an ale, or actually a wheat beer. I would probably do a half. Probably drink some Shock Top with this. Shock Top, Blue Moon, Oberon Ale from Bell's Brewing Company. I'm a fan of halves though. You can also do IPAs. The bitterness will go nicely with the sweetness of the shallots and the sauce. All the good flavors. Every time I hear somebody say, don't tell me what to do, I internally add, you're not my real mom. I like to go, you're not my supervisor. Archer. I gotta watch Archer, man. I gotta catch up on it. Oh, Miss Lula, I make ranch meatballs. It's just meatballs with ranch dressing powder, but they get dry. I don't run the heat up full either. Suggestions. Throw in an egg when you make your meatballs, and throw in a couple of tablespoons of oatmeal. Oatmeal works really well, or panko breadcrumbs, or breadcrumbs in general. Either one, oatmeal or breadcrumbs, will help juicify your meatballs. Adding an egg helps the meatballs stay together, and don't break apart while you're cooking them, so that helps as well, gives it structure. So, lots of options. I always use an egg, and I always use breadcrumbs or oatmeal. It's worked out so well for me. Oh, have you started the new season of Archer, Lula? Not yet. I'm working on it. Wee, Cloudberry, thank you so much for subscribing to the channel. Welcome to the convoy, Mother Trucker. Toot toot. Thank you so much for subscribing. I appreciate the support. Welcome, everybody in chat. Please welcome our new member of the convoy. Hello, hello. Welcome, welcome. You're awesome. Lulu, have you ever done a wine pairing on stream where you teach how to pair wine with different food? No. And the reason why is because I'm not good at that, and I don't want to give you false information. Juicify. I think I just added a new word to my vocabulary. Aw, yeah. Alrighty, so it looks like our meats are done cooking here. Like I said, if we cook it longer, it's just going to get dry. So let's get it out while the getting's good. Runaway meats, runaway meats. Yes, white meat like chicken, pork, white wine, red meat, red wine, which is why I'm gonna use a red wine in here. In a second, I gotta pop open the wine. It's wine time. It's wine time. It's wine time. Time to pop open the red wine. Woo! People use sherry, cooking sherry or cognac in beef stroganoff. And that's fine. I'm just using red wine because I like red wine, and that's all I have in my kitchen. And I'm just seeing if I have any juices. I guess not. Ow. So, it's time to cook the shallots. So we're going to cook these until they're translucent, and then and the onion flavor is less apparent. Man, I could really go for some vino. Alrighty, so we are gonna douse the shallots in some of that juice that we have here. And just to make sure everything's okay, we're gonna add some more olive oil just to make sure that we have cooking medium in here. Fuck wine, I love my Michigan beers. Oh, Luna, Michigan beers. I'm so jealous you guys have, freaking Bell's Brewing Company over there. So good. Also, do you have KBS over there? Kentucky Breakfast Stout? Because I will murder somebody for you to mail me a bottle of that. I'll trade you something for a couple of bottles of KBS if you have any. So after this, we're going to add our mushrooms in here, and we're going to cook down our mushrooms a lot. Founders. I have some metal towel. Oh my god. Let's trade. Send me a Twitch message. We can work something out. Okay, so it looks like we have these nice and translucent. I'm going to give it another minute. I'm going to check on the sourdough rolls. Sourdough rolls look good. Actually, I need to make
Oh, I need an egg wash. Egg wash.
I'm gonna turn down the heat here so I can have time to do this egg wash. Oh my god, doing this really, really fast. I always forget to do this. This is a step I always forget to do. I think Twitch is borked. It says I can announce my 5th month again. Alright, we'll do it. Why not? Do it, pussy. Alrighty, so we have our egg wash bin. I swear to god, I'm not fapping. French tips are the ultimate sophistication of woman manicure. Well, thank you. Yes, thank you. Alrighty, time to add the mushrooms here. A lot of mushrooms, 3/4 of a pound. Well, this is going to cook down a lot. We're going to get rid of a lot of the water content in these mushrooms, so it's not going to look as crazy mushroomy in a second. We will tone down the mushroomness as soon as the water content from the mushroom goes out. So I turned up the heat since we have, you know, more stuff in the pan. Trying to coat the mushrooms in the fats. It looks like we're gonna need more fats. I wish I had a gas stove. I'm not gonna lie, gas stoves are pretty legit. Pretty legit. Looks like we're gonna need more oil. Let me just try butter this time. Butter, mix it better. More butter. That was a lot of butter. That's like 3 tablespoons of butter right there, but that's okay. Butter makes everything better. Mushrooms are deceptive, huh? Looks like it's all been in there now. Yay. Paula Deen butter. Yes, yes. I wish I could stand the taste of butter. No. Can't stand the taste of butter? That's unfortunate. That's okay, though. I still love you. Still member of Team Lulaboo right now. Team Lulaboo cooking show. Here for you and your cooking needs every Tuesday and Thursday, except this week it's Tuesday and Wednesday for reasons that you will become more apparent to you tomorrow. Alright, so we're gonna cook this, we're gonna let this cook down while I take care of the sourdough rolls. Try portobello mushrooms. If you think regular mushrooms taste like dirt, try portobello mushrooms. Or oyster mushrooms or shiitake. Those are usually the really good ones that have a really separate, definite, different flavor from the rest. So as you can see, the mushrooms are already starting to come down in volume. I'm trying to make it so you guys can see this better. One sleep till Wednesday, yay. I did sprinkle olive oil in the pasta so it does not stick together. All aboard the hype train, I know, right? I threw cold water to the bottom of the oven after I stuck in the rolls and then threw the lid and then closed the oven door so we can get that nice steam injection going. So we're gonna let these cook down some more. All right, so this is gonna go down for a little bit longer, several more minutes. I'm going to make sure there's no skin on our stuff here, so I'm going to whisk that in again. Let it get hot a little bit over the heat of this stove. So I'm gonna turn up the heat a little bit, add maybe a little bit more beef broth, just to make sure it didn't evaporate too much right now. That seems like a lot of mushrooms, probably, but I like mushrooms, so I'll probably eat it all. I like mushrooms. This is not even a problem for me. Okay. I did not put a timer up for my sourdough, so I gotta check that out right now. Oh no. So I'm just gonna be watching the rolls like a hawk just to make sure that they're okay. Here we go. And this is cooking down quite nicely. I'm getting a nice aroma and flavors here. Let me see what the next directions say so we can look ahead and know what to do. Okay, so add mushroom saute to 8 to 10 minutes. Place meat plus juice into the pan. Mix it up, put aside. Deglaze pan and add the pan drippings to the sauce. Okay, reheat sauce, whisk in sour cream, mustard, dill, salt, pepper, pour over sauce and serve. Or pour over mix and serve. Alright, sounds good. We're pretty much almost done. I need to get that sour cream ready, actually. I'm going to throw in a splash of broth over here. Are you going to post this recipe anywhere? Yes, I have a food blog that you can check out, !!blog, and I'll probably post it up there. So while this is cooking off, I'm going to open up the red wine.
I need my red wine.
Got it. Nailed it. Yeah. Since the wine is open anyway, I'm just going to pour myself a glass. Alright guys, cheers everybody. Happy Tuesday. Hope you guys are having a great Tuesday. Cheers to you guys. Love you all. Thank you for being here and for the unyielding support. And everybody on Team Lula, thank you. Cheers. Did you go to school for the culinary arts? I went for baking and pastry. But I like to cook. Alright, so that looks like it's about as reduced down as it's going to get. I'm going to add in our meats. Jaded, thank you so much for being subbed for 7 months in a row. I appreciate the support. Thank you so much, Jaded, everybody. Everybody in chat, let's hype it up. Well, I don't have a hype emote. As soon as I get back to 100 emotes, I'm changing almost all of my emotes to stuff more relevant to today's cooking stream. Because I think it's necessary. So thank you, everybody. Let's get her the cat peep love out there. I am going to definitely update a lot of my stuff. I came back just in time for the meat. Yeah, girl. All right, I gotta taste test this, make sure it's okay. Oh yeah, definitely okay. Tastes great. Okay. So it's all coated, it's all mixed together, it's seasoned pretty well. Actually. No, it's good. I was gonna add more salt, I decided not to. If Tally wants more salt, he can add it in later. But this is really good. I'm really happy the way this turned out. So I'm gonna empty out this pan. And all these, everything that's stuck to this pan, I'm just gonna deglaze it out right now. To be fair, it's a non-stick pan, so not a lot stuck to it anyway, but we're gonna do it anyway. We're gonna deglaze the fuck out of this pan. Thank you so much for posting that food blog link. Appreciate it. Boop. Boop. Like I said, you can use any acid you want that you think is going to pair well. You can always do research. You can always figure it out. Like I said, people use cognac, sherry, beer, red wine vinegar, white wine vinegar, apple cider vinegar. I don't recommend actual white vinegar. So I'm going to let this reduce down a little bit, get a little bit thick. Lula, your meal prep video, you baked your chicken breasts at 350 degrees. Is there any reason why you baked them at 350 instead of 375 or 400? Generally, 350 degrees has been the international, it's just been a really standard number for any kind of baking in general in the oven. Oh wait, I gotta check the sourdough, hang on. They are not ready yet. All right, I had to check on them, it's been a while. It's a very common number. 350 degrees is kind of standard. Use some Malta, Lula. Malta. Yeah, good, you know, it's generally the lower temperature you go, the longer you have to cook it. So, for me, I can hit a good 30 minutes on boneless chicken in the oven and not have any problems. At 350 degrees. If you go down to 325, you're gonna have to extend it to like 45 minutes. If you go to 400, you're gonna have to shorten it out. But there's a chance, depending on how thick your chicken is, that it won't cook on the inside and it'll cook on the outside some more. So you just gotta find that happy medium, that balance. I'm getting burned. Oh, it got too dry. Are you serious? Where's that beef broth? You kidding me right now? I reduced it too low that it stuck to the pan. So I put in a splash of the beef broth so I can just kind of get everything in here out. So it's time to finalize our stroganoff. I'm hoping I can kind of wait on this because I really want those dinner rolls to be a little bit more cooked and all the way cooked before I plate the stroganoff. So I'm kind of doing this as slowly as I can. So we're going to reheat the stroganoff sauce right now. So we have a nice shot of red wine in there. We got some of the drippings from the bottom of the pan into the sauce. Things are going really well. Well, I'm glad I've been watching your meal prep video because I learned a lot so far. I've been making a lot of happy little accidents in meal prep, it seems. That's okay. Happy little accidents are okay because you can just it's practice, it's your practice to get better in the future. You have to in order to get better at something, you have to suck at it first. Like, sucking at something is the first step to being good at something. Let's just put it that way. Does pounding help it cook, or what does it do for you when you do? If you have an uneven piece of meat, let's just say you have a piece of chicken breast, and you know how it's thicker on one side of the breast from the tail end, it's not the same size. If you pound your chicken to having the same overall thickness as the rest of the chicken, so it all remains uniform and the same, it's going to cook more evenly in the oven, or you know, on the stove or whatever it is that you're doing. It's not going to have off even sides, and it helps tenderize the beef a little bit, or the meat a little bit. Alright, so let me put the dill in here. I'm about to whisk in the dill. We're whisking in dill, sour cream. I forgot the rest. So let's see here. Whisk in sour cream, mustard, dill, salt, and pepper, and pork.
Alrighty.
Just put in some salt. Put in some pepper. Where's my pepper? Pepper, where are you? Oh, there you are. Salt, pepper, don't forget to taste it to make sure the seasoning's okay. Here's the dill. And then 3 tablespoons sour cream. And mustard. Ooh, chicken schnitzel. I do want to try schnitzel. That is something on the Lula to-do list, is chicken schnitzel. But Tally has requested a recipe for next week. So next week on Tuesday, we are making chicken cordon bleu on Tuesday. Alright, I gotta check on the sourdough. Okay, so 1, 2, 3. And then we have to put our mustard. This is horseradish mustard, so it's gonna give it a little bit of a different kick. Ew. I know I shouldn't have done that, but that was kinda gross, but it's okay. That was very unsanitary and gross. Tally's so white. No, I was asking him for ideas. I was asking him for ideas of what to make on the stream. He's like, why don't you try chicken cordon bleu? I'm like, fucking genius, because I didn't think about it. I don't know why. I didn't think about making chicken cordon bleu. Chicken cordon bleu is one of those things that they had in the mid to late 1900s. You know, so the 50s, 60s. No, more like the 70s, 80s, 90s. It was a very popular dish and at the upscale restaurant scene. And not so much anymore. They have, you know, cooking changes. Fads for cooking change over time. Alright, I gotta taste test this thing on. Stuffed meat then. It's stuffed chicken stuffed with ham and cheese. And breaded on the outside, I believe. So which means it means that we're gonna have to make a complete dinner, so I'm thinking chicken cordon bleu with scalloped potatoes as a starch. And I gotta think about a veggie. What do you guys think about veggies? What should I do for the vegetable dish? Ooh, it's very tangy. It's very tangy. Probably because of the Dijon mustard with the horseradish in it. And you know what? I'm alright with that. I think it's okay. I like it. Seasoning is actually pretty good. We don't have to change anything with the seasoning. Oh, not at all. Mmm. You know me, guys. I like my my acid tanginess. Looks like this is all done. It's good to go. It's time to plate. Brussels sprouts or asparagus? Yeah, I'm going to go Brussels sprouts or asparagus. I think that'll be good. Lula, I'm sure you've answered this before, but who's your favorite celebrity chef? Alton Brown is one of them. I'm going to say another one would be Chef Miyamoto from Iron Chef. I like Miyamoto. And I like Ina Garten. I like the Barefoot Contessa. She's not my absolute favorite, but she's up there. She has really good recipes. Actually, her recipe for spinach cheese souffle is what I'm going to use probably on Thursday then next week. Tuesday, Thursday. So Tuesday, chicken cordon bleu. Thursday, cheese souffle. What do you guys think? Emeril Lagasse, I like too. I'm a fan of Emeril. He doesn't do much nowadays, but he still does a good job. Yeah, got a taste test, you know. It sounds really good. Yeah! Bam!
I'm gonna switch their dinner rolls.
Dinner rolls are nearly done, so let me get everything ready to start plating. We're pretty much like at 5 minutes left for the dinner rolls.
So I'm gonna put some stuff away really quick and let's get ready to plate. I wanna plate this bitch.
I'm allergic to nuts, why you do this to me? Wait, why? What? Oh, you know what though? I am a fan of Gordon Ramsay. I do like Gordon Ramsay's cuisine. Now that you're talking about raw scallops. They're fucking raw! Yeah. Total Gordon Ramsay fan. Total douchebag, but he knows what he's doing. Well, he's a douchebag to dumb chefs. I would probably get yelled at him if I ever ended up in Hell's Kitchen. My ass would get reamed by Gordon Ramsay. He would totally like yell at me, and I'm sure I'll do something stupid because, you know, it's a reality TV show and the pressure's on and I'm not thinking. Yep. I'll probably be the first one to get yelled at by Gordon Ramsay. Pretty much.
I'm more than sure. He's a douchebag on American TV, but he's a lot less asshole-y on British TV. That's what I hear. Did anybody watch the Archer episode of Bastard Chef that Anthony Bourdain voiced? I thought that was a really funny episode. And because he was sitting there and he was the voice of basically him, and he was doing a reality show called Bastard Chef. I thought it was really hilarious. I would ream him. Me too. Ramsay would yell at me and I would cry, and I'm sensitive like that, but me too. Well, I don't know about... Yeah, I'd probably cry. Also, even though he's not as big of a celebrity chef, I gotta give it to Chef John from foodwishes.com. Dude could whisper sweet nothings in my ears and smooth with that smooth voice of his. America likes their assholes. They really do. They really do. I like Guy Fieri. Americans are more entertained with that Hell's Kitchen. They really are.
Oh my god, they really are. So we're gonna switch this out because we're gonna get this ready for plating. So I'm just getting the area ready. Guy Fieri is okay, in my opinion. If you like him, that's awesome.
Dude, that Diners, Drive-Ins, and Dives show, like, I will watch Guy Fieri eat all that shit. I am down. That is quality programming for me when I get to watch him take down diner food like a boss. Putting stuff away because I gotta do more dishes. My dish rack is full, so I have to empty it out so I can do more dishes. I have a lot of dishes right now. They look good. They're just barely starting to get color. I want them to get a little bit. We want those dinner rolls to get a little bit more color before we continue. Because they're like still, they're starting to get some color on the top, but they're like totally bleach white on the bottom. So I'm gonna give it a few more minutes. I raised the temperature of the oven from 400 to 450 so that we can get that browning in. And so now I'm watching it like a hawk because I don't want it to overcook. Wait, what? I'm at work and my customer started watching Lula with me. Well, thank you. I appreciate it. You're awesome. Hello. Hello, Basti and the customer. What's up? Welcome to my channel, twitch.tv/Lulaboo, where you can watch cooking streams live. I cook stuff live for better or for worse, Tuesdays and Thursdays at 1 o'clock p.m. Pacific Standard Time. My job blocked Twitch. That sucks. Aww. Working from home with bronchitis like a boss and get to watch Lula's cooking show. Well, thank you, Corylin. Thanks for watching. Okay, so almost there, you guys. I don't mean to make you, like, we're totally in a holding position right now. I don't mean to, but it's just halfway. We're in a little bit of a holding pattern. And I'm just kind of doing some cleanup so I can minimize how much I have to clean up once the stream is over. Legit, I spend about 2 hours cleaning after the stream is over. So I'm just trying to minimize that right now. Alright, dinner rolls are ready! Dinner rolls are ready! Oh, god damn it! What did I burn? Anything, I swear.
I don't know what happened. I know the fire alarm goes off. It went off for like a second.
I'm not sure what it caught. I really think it's temperature specific. Hang on. I think it's temperature specific because it's really freaking hot in here, so I turned on the AC.
Ooh, I guess I can see what it burns. The tops of these, a little bit burned. That's okay. It's weird because bottom rack oven, top rack oven are so different when it comes to, you know. Top rack, bottom rack. Totally can see the difference. That little bit of a distraction I got with the fire alarm really, like, this was perfect color until the fire alarm went off. And then when the fire alarm went off, I got fucked. So, whatever, what am I gonna do? Alrighty. I'm gonna wait till these cool off. Lula, I got my scale. I actually used it that day. Thank you. You are welcome, Dasip. Thanks for watching. That's okay, you guys. It looks like I'm gonna have to hold it back anyway because that nice crust that I get from sourdough appeared here, so now I have hard crust sourdough. That's okay. So for the sake of my food blog, I'm just kinda put a picture up here. I'm gonna put a nice picture here so I can like screenshot it later for my food blog. Dinner rolls, I guess. Whatever. Time to plate. It's time. So anyway, sourdough in general ends up with a really hard crust on the outside, which I totally forgot that that's the case when I do the steam injection at the beginning of the baking process. So for dinner rolls in general, you do not want that crusty crust on top. So next time I will axe the steam injection at the beginning just so we can get a softer crust just because they're dinner rolls. For some weird ass reason, the bottom of my oven heats hotter than the top. It's like, what the fuck? Mine is the exact opposite. The top is hotter than the bottom. Alrighty, so here we go. We're gonna add our egg noodles in here. We're gonna have a nice bed of egg noodles on this bitch because I really like this stuff. And we're gonna put a nice, you don't want to make it a pointed pile, you kind of want to make it a nice flat base pile because we're gonna add the meat mushroom mix and the sauce. So you want to kind of like flatten it out a little bit here so you have room to put in your sauce and your meat and your mushroom mix. And if you have leftover stuff, like I'm going to have leftover stuff like this, I'm going to make omelets tomorrow and I'm going to stuff the shit out of my omelets in the morning with this stuff right here if I have leftovers. That's a big if, you guys. Alrighty. Okay, time for the sauce. Oh, Lula, your nails are on point today. Thank you, I love my nails today. I'm a fan of the French. I have nail wraps that I want to use, but I'm saving them for TwitchCon. Alright, so we're going to put our Stroganoff sauce on top. Now, you don't want to go crazy with the Stroganoff. You don't. Does not need too much. Does not need a lot. Here's our dinner roll. Oh, I'm gonna put it over here actually. Alright, so I'm gonna take a picture of this. Ba-dum! Here we go. Hang on, I gotta get the placing right on this. Alright, so this is my beef stroganoff made from scratch with sourdough dinner rolls, which we still have to try out, see if they're any good. Yay! I gotta take a picture, hang on. I gotta take a picture, man, for posterity, the food blog and stuff. I've been trying to keep that up, and I'm trying to use, like, pretty pictures just to make sure, more sauce on top. Trust me, it's a lot of, I don't have a lot of sauce, so I have to, like, you know, just kind of ration it out for another serving, you know what I'm saying? Alrighty, so, let me take a picture. So I'm on Twitter. At fail_Lula or same thing, Instagram at fail_Lula. Hope you guys like it. Oh my god, Cece's pregnant. Nice. Hang on a second. It's a dirty picture. Hang on. Okay, let's try it out. Gotta take that picture. Got the most well-lit food pictures right now with my, like, camera. I'm gonna take another picture. There we go. Yay, so beef stroganoff, and then we have sourdough dinner rolls. Alrighty, on Twitter. So if you can, guys, for the sake of social media, please retweet the shit out of this. I could use the exposure, I guess you can say. It's really nice. Alright, so it's time. I actually want to take the one I cracked open.
I want to take the dinner roll I cracked open and cut it open. See how it's like.
Dude, seriously, the dinner rolls are very crusty. Like, super crusty. Which is the way sourdough is supposed to be. If you go on the inside, it's very nice and tender. Very nice. I like it. So it's just crispy on the outside, still tender on the inside, which is perfect. This is what I consider a really good crumb. We did a really good job with this. I'm really happy with this. I like the crusties on the outside. It's really cool. Alright, so now it's time to mix it together. Alrighty, so let me move this out of the way. I'm gonna start mixing this together right now. It's time for taste testing. Sauce plus roll. Yeah, buddy. Okay. I gotta like use my other hand kind of to toss it. It would be gross if it was being served to somebody else, but since it's just me, I can do whatever the hell I want. So next week, chicken cordon bleu, and then we're gonna try and make a souffle. Wish me luck for that. So here we go, you guys. Cheers. Here we see how it goes. Oh shit. Gotta do this again. A little bit of mushroom, a little bit of beef, a little bit of noodle. Come on. Work with me here, noodles. Alright. Oh, this is really good. I really like this. tanginess from the tanginess from the sour cream really works well with this sauce. I picked a really good red wine because it complements it really nicely. Like all the flavors, just the red wine flavors, the tanginess from the sour cream, the beef broth in general, just all kind of really comes together really nicely. The dill comes out too, which gives it another, you know. Yeah, I need a bowl. But for pretty plating purposes, I used to
use that.
All right, time to try the sourdough. Sourdough smells good. Definitely can smell more dough development in there. I'm gonna wipe it with some sauce in here. Crunchy outside, crunchy, very delicious. Inside's really tender. Flavor development on that starter dough is starting to show up. Not very heavy, but it's really light, but still really good. Don't get cheap wine when you cook with wine. Better the wine, the better the flavor. That is, I agree wholeheartedly with that. I drink cheap wine, but cook with expensive wine. Jasper, I do the same thing. Well, I buy a whole bottle of a good wine. If I have to use it to cook, then I'll just drink the whole bottle. I'll like use the, you know, the half a cup that I need for a recipe, and then I'll just drink the rest. Because I can, because I'm an adult. This is really good, you guys. This is really good. The bread's really good. I think we did it! We did it! Yes! Oh, it's so good. It's so good. I would just put everything in my mouth all at once, and it's just so good. And then I just gotta try it with the wine, too. We did it! Yes! Oh, I'm so happy. I'm so happy right now. I will have this recipe up on the food blog this weekend, hopefully. This is sour cream. There's sour cream in the sauce. This is so good. This is really good. And with the wine, it's just so perfect. 10 out of 10, I would recommend this recipe again. I got this recipe off of Epicurious's website, epicurious.com. And it's really good. I'm gonna have to try some more of their stuff soon. Hi, honey, I just finished. Or I'm about to finish. Time for the Towie taste test, you guys! No, you have to do it now. Time for the Towie taste test, boys. I got pictures and stuff. It's really good. It's very tangy. Okay. What's that? Right here. Let me know what you think, and then those are the sourdough dinner rolls.
Oh, nice. Oh, my size of the wheat.
What do you think? Oh, good. You want more sauce?
No more.
Is it good?
Very good.
Tally approves! Tally approves!
General?
Yes! Yeah, that's General. Sourdough. It's not quite sour yet, it'll get there. What do you think? Tally likes both! We did it, you guys. Tally liked it. Tally taste test is a pass. I love it! This is good! Alright, so this recipe is gonna show up on the food blog. I'm gonna have nice, pretty pictures and screenshots. Really shitty quality screenshots, but I'll do my best. So tune in tomorrow where I'm going to make pasta from scratch. Assuming my pasta maker comes in, it hasn't even come in yet, so I'm a little worried. But if not, we'll cross that bridge when we get there tomorrow. I'm still doing pasta Alfredo no matter what. So I might have to just buy noodles and then make the Alfredo and then make the garlic bread myself. So I will see you guys tomorrow. I'm pretty much done. I gotta clean this up. My kitchen is a mess. I will see you guys tomorrow. Please tune in tomorrow, 1 p.m. Pacific Standard Time. And we get to do some shrimp Alfredo action. It's going to be fun. It's going to be fun. I can't wait. I'll see you guys tomorrow. You guys have a wonderful evening. Peace, love. Have a happy day. I am going to host somebody else.